In the Communication Sciences and Disorders program here at James Madison University, we have a vision, and our vision was developed by our faculty. And our consensus was that we want to bridge science and clinical practice. What this means is that we want our students to understand the science that underlies what they're hoping to practice in, and that this will drive them to be able to make good decisions, to be problem solvers as they face a child in the school environment, as they face a stroke patient that's in a rehab facility. So we want them to be able to be good thinkers. The PhD program, which is the Doctorate of Philosophy, is in Communication Sciences and Disorders. And this degree program can focus on someone that is interested in focusing in audiology, speech-language pathology, or also in the speech and hearing sciences. Our students have a fairly open curriculum. They have four courses that are their core coursework. They have courses that are required in terms of statistics and their research tools. But beyond that, they really get to map out what they want their program to be. And this is so they can be experts in the area that is their passion.
The first thing a student does is form a committee of three faculty members, and then they sit down together and they talk about the goals of the student. Where do they want to end up? What are their professional interests? And they work out a plan, and that involves courses possibly. But we stress lab work, so we want to get the students out of the classroom as much as possible and into our research labs.
From day one, they start to engage students in research. They ask you about your interest areas and what topics you'd be interested in conducting research, and are there any professors who you'd be interested in working with. So almost immediately I started engaging in research and kind of fine-tuning my interests and the projects that I was interested in participating with.
You're also working on your research, but also usually closely with another professor on their research, and that's when you're building your skills and learning more about the field and more about the area that you want to become an expert in.
So the research labs are great. We can do clinical work up here, but our students can also do real-world clinical work as part of their PhD.
We do have an autism clinic that is on site. There's also the schools in the area that we work in, and we have the hospital, so there's a variety of different clinical opportunities that you can have while you're here.
The CSD department has a collaboration with RMH, the hospital, and so I've been able to keep my clinical skills very current. I have privileges at RMH.
I liked the flexibility of the program. They allowed me to start my PhD program during my master's program, which seemed overwhelming at first, but with their support, it wasn't at all, and it's just been a really smooth transition.
The biggest interest of our students when they leave here is to go on to an academic position.
One thing that is very unique about our PhD program is that all students are required to do a mentored teaching class and experience.
It trains a student in all of the things that they'll need to be hopefully a very good teacher and a very good researcher and a great faculty member at another university. But that's not all. It depends on the students. Some of our students, for example, who've graduated in the past have been owners of businesses and are practicing in that way.
Because of the great reputation that the school has and the program has, when you leave here to go other places, just having JMU as something you can talk about and your experiences here has been really beneficial.
We have fabulous labs, we have an amazing clinic, great outreach in the community, but our faculty, the mentor is the most important person to the student. And our faculty are very student-oriented, and we're accessible, and I think we're a very friendly faculty. And look at their accomplishments, and you'll see why a student should pick JMU.
It's a very supportive environment. I've always felt really supported here. And there's always someone willing to listen, willing to help, willing to give me ideas about things or just listen to ideas that I have if they're practical. So it's been a really great place to be.